Hello, my lovelies. Welcome back to another full build kit review. This will be AMT's 2021 Dodge Charger Pursuit police car. It's in 1/25th scale. As you can see, it's an extra big box. It's bigger than your standard model box because this thing is packed from the bottom to the top with parts. And I mean a lot of parts. This is one of those kits, if you take it all out of the box before you build it, good luck getting it all back in there in the right order. We can see a look at that awesome California Highway Patrol livery, which is included. We've got police lights on this thing. It's got the V8 Hemi under the hood. We got police wheels and other stuff. So let's start taking a look at everything that will be in the box. I will link to the description for pre-orders on this kit if they are available. If pre-orders or the kits are not available at the time this video runs, then I will put them in the description as soon as I have those links available. On the plastic parts, I have built the 21 Charger before, so you've seen a lot of these parts before. We're going to build the kit again because it is the police car mode now with new and additional parts. But we can see our front and rear bumpers here and bumper covers. And because it's a modern style kit, they include all these nice mounting pegs and holes for the lights, for the grills. See these holes here? This helps us mount it on the body so we can paint the parts up individually and then attach them later to the lovely Charger body. Check out all these points, these overlaps that allow you to get a little bit of glue in there. We've got all of our lower trim that we can attach on all these tabs, and same with the rear. We've got some pegs to line it up. You saw those little U-shaped hooks on the rear bumper, and then they just interlock right in there and slide over the sides and interlock, and we hold our different body panels together. We got antenna mounts, windshield wiper mounts, mirror mounts on the sides. We've got all of our mirror mounts on the inside. We've got dimples to drill holes for our wigwags on the top. All kinds of stuff. See the holes back there for the optional spoiler on the civilian version that I built? I did a nice orange and black custom version of this ride prior. So on this one, we've got the standard seating. We got the sport seats in the front, extra supportive, and then we've got the regular back seats on there. Look excellent on the kit. We see we got to put some backs on them. They got large location marks for the chassis to go into. There is just so much stuff in this box. This one here, we've got front suspension. We've got various components. We've got shock towers and struts. We've got oil pan and transmission. We got our struts right there. We got the front of our engine, skid plates and heat shields, all kinds of gadgets and doodads. Here we've got our posable steering pieces, sway bar link, tie rod, front or rear suspension, belt and pulley system, armrests, differential and drive shaft, and joint CV joints are all one piece on there. Lovely dashboard. We can see that it's smooth, which will tell us that we've got some decaling to do when we get to that point of our build. Here are some police car parts added in. We've got a center console with radio. We've got our cage in the back with glass insert to come. We've got our push bar, grill with large openings. We've got our pedestal mount and swivel for our police computer with touchscreen. Isn't that cool? All kinds of police parts. I'm sure you can spot more on that tree. Feel free to pause it and take a look. So you can still build the stock Charger, but or you can build the police version, which is really cool. Also included in this version are a set of stock wheels and police steelies. Black steel, all the ventilation holes, just like the box art. And we knew those were coming because we saw some parts when we did the other Charger build. On this one, we've got our lower body trim, our exhausts, and our hood. This will be a two-tone paint job on this. Shouldn't be too hard to duplicate. Here we'll have some more stock parts, but we've got our rotors and brakes, seat backs, regular center console, grills, upper console, little shift levers. So keep an eye on that. You're all going to have those as extra parts. Door panels. We saw the armrests that go into the door panels. Air dam. We've got our steerable front spindles. Windshield wipers are molded in white. There's not a lot of chrome on these real cars, and I like that they left it that way so that we can paint them and detail them without having to get chrome in the way on stuff that shouldn't be chrome anyways. Engine block and transmission, individual fans for the engine, stock steering wheel, optional spoiler. You could have a police car with a spoiler. You never know what options they threw on there every now and then. Catalytic converter. We've got our mirrors. When you cut the mirrors, make sure you don't cut them flush. Those pins are supposed to be on there, and they're very small. Steering column with turn signal, heat shields, radiator, another heat shield. And this one here, we have our chassis plate, firewall, valve covers, engine cover, or intake, actually. See all those lovely parts on there, all the interior pieces. Underneath, they'll have markings to drill it out for certain accessories. You can see there. There. So follow the instructions, drill out the correct areas to build your police car model. We've got our lower chassis pan. Isn't that lovely to see? All these mounting locations for suspension, front suspension. Love that they didn't leave these as separate pieces. So we know our suspension should sit flat. Fan covers, the rest of our exhaust with attachment points. Inner wheels, and the upwards of the chassis for all of our mounts and body and everything. So we know we'll get our front suspension on correctly and our rear suspension without having to worry about having it be three-wheel motion. On the other side of the table, we've got this sweet decal sheet. California Highway Patrol, the Chippies. We've got the blue line flag. We've got our reds and blue lights. We've got our tail lights. We've got our marker lights. We've got our police computer. We've got our stock radio and gauges. More blue lines. We got more light indicators as if they're turned on when the car is sitting. So you can have the lights activated on like the brush guard, or you can just have them be white as if they weren't turned on yet, the LEDs. Hemi logos, all the police logos in black and matching white. Got a nice gold metallic tint to those highway patrol decals. California plates on there. Our call-outs for the squad numbers on the roof. And then our interior dash, touchscreen, all that intelligent driving. Nice decal sheet on there. From round two, all the stuff we need. Then we get into the singular chrome tree, which will have our taillights, our headlight pieces, our wigwag bar, our police hubcaps for those nice steelies, the inserts for the mirrors, rear view mirror, all that kind of stuff that we need on there, exhaust tips and everything, and not overdone on the chrome. On this special tree here, here's the glass for our wigwags, top and bottom. We've got our glass for the screen, for the cage, and our marker lights. That's a new part. Got our nice singular red tail light. Excellent work on that. And our last clear parts tree. We got our door glass, back glass, headlight covers, marker lights, all done. Crystal clear styrene. We've got a set of four tires. These are not name branded. And excellent tread pattern on those. Very scale tread pattern. They look exquisite. Finally, you guys are going to be really happy with this one. Remember, I had to mask off all the other stuff. Check it out. Pad printed front and rear glass. No more having to paint. No more having to mask or worry about it. It's even got the drop down for the mirror. Even got the opening for the taillight. Oh yeah, round two. Way to make me happy. Excellent job getting those pad printed, flat black on the inside like they should be, showing through as gloss on the outside. Wonderful, wonderful work. So that is a lot of stuff. I'm going to get to gluing mine together, and you can follow me with that right now.
Thank you.
Since this is a modern kit, a lot of stuff can be left on the trees, painted and assembled later. They've accommodated for that with the large locators on the kit, the holes in the body or the holes you will drill out when you want to use them, and stuff like attaching the front and rear clips. We don't have to worry about getting those attached and then try to fit things together later. We can do it all in order, just like the manual wants us to. What I'm going to do is get parts painted on the trees. Some of this stuff, like the brush guard, the grills, the mounts, I want to get that all painted. And then things like the cage, I want to do in a metallic tone. So I will paint that later in a metallic tone, but I'll paint them all on the tree right now to get them primed. We've got our door panels, all set up with their switches and their mounts. They couldn't get that all molded in one piece, so they did it separately. We got our windshield wipers, be careful of those, and our front spoiler. And we've got stuff like the radiator, air cleaner, the side mirrors, all to be painted up, primed, and then glossed and painted later. Same with our clips on the front and rear. We've got the steering column all set up with its column shifter. The police cars have it on the column so that they can have their equipment in the center console. With this computer here, isn't that neat? Little police computer, we'll paint that up. We'll get the decal on there, and you'll be able to see that from the outside of the car. Then on the interior piece, I've got the mount for that computer in the floor. We've got our holes drilled out for that rear wall and for the rear lights that'll be on the package shelf. We've got our suspension built up. That's all ready to go. Differential CVs. We've got our independent rear suspension with our drive shaft. We got a heat shield here and here. We've got a cross member and two heat shields around there. I can easily hand paint all that stuff, so I enjoy putting it on. Now, we've got our front suspension, and the front suspension will steer. If you don't lock it up with glue, you can still steer those spindles. Got our sway bar mounted on, front suspension, and strut towers, and our struts hiding underneath. All easy peasy. It's a little tedious, but it's not hard to assemble, again, being a very modern kit. We've got that big Hemi all put together. Our manifolds actually attach underneath the cylinder heads, and then the valve covers over that. So I'll paint this up, decorate it as I need to, and most of it will be hid by the large engine cover as we go down. I'm not going to do the car rusted or anything like that, like the manifolds. We got our belt and pulley system with our alternator, power steering. I will paint that, and then I will attach that to the front of the motor. It goes on there super easy. We just end up a little guide hole there, and that's how it all mounts up with the modern serpentine system and gets it all put together. So for the most part, we're dealing with the exact same kit as we did with the RT, with all the cool police parts on it. The hood will paint separately. There are no options for hood hinges. It's just a flat fitting hood. We've got the holes drilled out for the wigwags on top and the pillar lights on passenger and driver's side, because those are included right there. And be very, very careful. They've made those mounts so very small. Be super careful painting and handling. We've got our antenna mount already in there. We drill those holes out from underneath, or you can leave them as is if you want to build a stock Hemi charger. As far as the engine cover goes, we've got that piece right there. It just presses in. And our dashboard. And pretty much that's it. I've got the exhaust separately. The wheels just have their snap-in rings. So I didn't even put that on the video. Those just press in. Got our parts, got our interior with our seat backs attached. And after you do all that, or you could do even less, we will start getting things over into paint, where I'm going to primer stuff. I'm going to lay final colors down as far as the body. We're going to have to do two-tone on the body to get it painted up that way. And then I will see all of you at the paint booth.
Thank you.
There is a whole lot to do to get to this point. All kinds of stuff to work on. So many parts. We've got some small parts that are left to be attached after we do our final assembly. Things like putting the mirrors on, getting those in the little holes on the side. I have to install the spotlights on either side. I've got the lenses glued in there, and you saw me chrome those out so that we can install the lenses. It looks like they have a big reflector. We've got to put our front and rear clips on. And now remember, like I showed you in the build session, make sure you put your reflector, your red lens, then your decals on for the back lights. And on this one here, we've got a nice brush guard installed with the siren. We've got our headlights installed and our grille blankouts, no fog lights on this one. So those are set. We've got to put our lower trim pieces on the body once the body is attached. Windshield wipers have to go on. And the radio antenna, don't forget that little guy back there, goes on once I decide what roof decals I want to apply or how I want to apply them. We've got the interior all set to go. And that is exquisite. Now, I didn't use a black-on-black interior because of being a scale model, it would be very difficult to see any detail or anything. So what I did was I did the black vinyl seat in the back for the perps. No cushions, no nothing. I want it to look like hard plastic back there. Then I put in the metal with rubber surround and the glass and the cage for the passenger in the back. For the perp, we've got our lights. Now, I haven't colored any of these lights on the light bars or the interior. My car is sitting still. There's no one in it and stuff like that. So we're going to say that the lights aren't on in my version. But you can color these in. You could use the decals to color the lights in and set them up if you want it as if the car is running. And I'm guessing the aftermarket, once they see these lights here, are going to be, you know, getting some small surface mount LEDs and stuff for you folks to install. These are clear lights on the back, and they mount with their clear posts, so you could actually put LEDs underneath and it would shine through. So we've got our awesome little laptop computer. I did the keys in a silver, which makes them look like they're those glow keys, those light up keys that you would use at night on a laptop. And then I just did a Tamiya black wash inside there. You saw me color up the radio equipment. We got the seats in place. I did the seats and the dashboard and the door panels in a very, very dark gray, black seat, flat black carpet, black console, black steering wheel, and a gray dash with all of its instrumentations, and it just looks great. You squad car lovers are gonna really enjoy this and do it up in your color schemes and all that, and whatever you want. But I wanted things to kind of show up on camera, so I did a little bit of a dark gray. I did the metallic cage back there and all that on there, and it really stands out nicely. We got our front and rear clips. We go to the body, they give you two entire light bars. Now, where each LED is, you could color that in, of course, but the LEDs on all the light bars that I see, when they're not on, they just look like this. They just look like a plastic covered light bar. Only when they switch the LEDs on do we get the blues and the reds wigwagging. So I decided to go with the more clear lamp. That's the one I'm using, has its different mounts. I made sure it fit on there, but you, of course, can always use the one with the finned top on the glass, and it has its own mount, so you get two entire light bars. You could mount these on other vehicles as well. Pretty cool. And then the hood obviously drops into place without a problem. We got our glass in. Isn't that awesome that the glass is painted? Since we're doing a squad, I didn't have to paint anything around the windows. I left the front windows out. I didn't want them in my car. I left them out. I did install the rear, and I used a black Sharpie to do the little division here on the glass. You'll see it. There you go. You can see where it's on there. And that's it for the body itself. Got all that glass in and everything. So I'm going to put everything together. I have to attach the interior to the chassis. And hold on, the chassis is drying. Give me a second to show you that. I needed to walk into a completely different area of this shop, and I forgot that that was drying over there. So we've got our radiator mounted, radiator hose, we got our air box, our reservoir tank, our battery box, our other reservoir tank. We got our Hemi logos on the engine. I even went on mine a little fancier. A guy in the motor pool put some silver on the V8 logos. We got that sweet police package wheel and tire set on there. And you can see the underbody with all the heat shields and everything else underneath it. Looks great. The contrasting colors of the way I painted things. We got a really nice looking chassis. So the interior has these large holes. The chassis has its pins. And that's where I will install that on. Then the body will squeeze over the top and snap on. Then we'll put our front and rear clips on, our lower trim. I'll add the mirrors, the light bars, the antenna, the decals. And when I do all that, I will come back with the final. So anyone who was paying attention when I built the first 21 Dodge Charger RT, when I built that car and I custom painted it, we know that we saw some parts on there that were going to relate to a future release, or at least I guessed. And those were this little mini hubcaps here. Those were on the previous release, but that was it. All the rest of this stuff for the police car model is just on this one. And we knew that, or at least thought, I guessed, I don't have any idea what's coming out from these companies. They really don't tell me, and if they did, I really wouldn't want to discuss them because you never know when something's going to be delayed. But they didn't tell me. I just guessed that we would be seeing a police car version, knowing how much you guys love utility vehicles and city vehicles, municipal, police cars and all that. And of course, here we go. Now coming out in 2024 will be the 21 Dodge Charger Pursuit. It's got the big Hemi under the hood. We've got a lot of police specific parts on the molds. We got these gorgeous steel wheels and hubcaps. We have these excellent spotlights. We have not just one set of wigwags, but two. And I mean complete, the mounts and everything. You don't have to decide which one you want. You could swap out both. You could light one. You could paint some of it if you want it to look like the lights are on. We've got the brush guard, the speaker, the police lights on it. We've got the non-spoilered back end, though the spoiler is included. And on the interior, we have some really awesome parts. We have the computer. We have the entire new center console with the radio and the two microphones. All those goodies inside the box. And of course, the kit goes together just like the excellent 21 Charger RT that I built. There really is no issue. When you want to drop the body on the chassis, you don't have the rear or front fascias on it. You just simply, I just set the chassis on the table. The interior press fits to the chassis. And then I just spread the doors and drop it right down on the chassis. Then all we have to do is press on the rear bumper. The rear bumper is held in place by friction and the exhaust. The exhaust fits so perfectly and tightly underneath the rear bumper that it holds that rear fascia on. The front fascia is also just held on with friction. It almost kind of snaps in place, and I don't have any glue holding it on whatsoever. You can see under the car, I hope the hood won't fall off, how that exhaust is perfectly lined up. The exhaust tips are friction fit. There's no hunting, there's no fighting. They just go on and they fit. The decals lay down beautifully. We got our little wigwags on the rear window, so if you want to color those in or use the decals, we've got them on the front push bar. You can use the colored decals if you want it to look like the car is actually running. And of course, it does have front windows, but I left them out. I like that so I can see inside and take pictures of the interior. I did put the rear windows in, of course, and it's got the little back side lights and everything. It's got the cage in there with the glass and even the foam insulation to seal it against the body and all that. It's very well designed. Excellent job by Round 2. Can't recommend these Charger kits enough. They go together so sweet. They look awesome. And now you folks that love these cars will get to own a police car version of it. And I know those will sell very well because the aftermarket is going to go bazonkers with local, state, you know, and regional DNR logos, police, highway patrol, little local PDs and podunk PDs. You're all going to be able to get these awesome, cool decals for all these squad cars you're going to make. Back on the roof of the car, I chose my numbers. You can see them on there and in the pictures. Tell me in the comment what kind of Easter egg I made with those numbers on the roof. If you know, you know, and you'll laugh about it. The rest of you can read the comments, find out what that is, and look it up. So I want to thank Round 2 Models for sending over this sweet little Pursuit Mode Dodge Charger. I hope you're having a great day. I hope you're having fun out there. When you get your model, I want you to build it your way for you and just have a good time, because always remember, the core of this channel is, it's a hobby, we're here to have fun, and that's what I like to do. I will see all of you at the next review.